chapter number 24, he is crying out for something he never had before. He's at a point to where he's conditioned and walking with the people. And in shift sometimes, certain things happen. And certain people don't want to go along with it. Everybody on your road can't understand why you praising God the way you praising God. Y'all sitting next to the wrong person. Everybody don't know how God kept you. Everybody don't know your story. Can you look at somebody real quick and say, you may not understand my story, but when I open my mouth, you won't understand the glory. He's getting the glory. He gonna give me the story. Because when I think of his goodness and all that he's done for me, I gotta get to the cloud and give him glory. Can I get about 50 praises in the building? Which means he's on a level with everybody else. Watch this. I'm on the same level with y'all. I'm in the struggle just like y'all struggle. Watch this. He says, I need you to shift. Come on, somebody say shift, shift, shift. So he says, I need to elevate you a little bit higher. Now that I'm elevated, I can see above you. So I can see what you can't see. Because I'm at a height advantage. And the thing about it is the enemy has robbed you this year of your height advantage because you ain't been praying like the way you're supposed to be praying. He tell you to fast, you only fasted for 1 hour. Y'all ain't never been. You just like the disciples that fell asleep on Jesus. You can't watch and pray with me for yes 1 hour. It's just because you're too much in your flesh. You too tired. You too drained. I'm too tired to go to church. You ain't even realizing what the leader gotta go through just to be prepared to serve you on a different level. Y'all ain't hearing me. You don't know what the praise and worship team has to endure all week long and get up here and still elevate you in a place of worship. Look at somebody real quick and say, you gotta shift next year. Get on up a little bit higher. Come on, tell somebody shift. Yeah. So he says, get to the mountaintop. Get to the mountaintop. The first level, he elevates his height. Come on, sir. You're right here. Come on, stand right here. Come on, stand on this side. He says, make sure you're at the right place at the right time because I'm going to shift you. Satan, Simon Peter, had decided to have you that he may sift you as wheat. But I pray for you that your faith fail you not. I didn't pray that the sifting would stop. I pray that your belief outlasts the sifting. I wish I had about 5 people in the building that says I'm holding on. Not because of how much money I gave in the offering. I'm holding on because I must first believe. And what you must understand that he that cometh to God must first believe that he is. And that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Is there anybody in the building that still believe God? Open your mouth and say, God, I still believe. I still believe.
Certain folk off.
afraid. And it's like some of us. We like here. We in the cloud, but we still want to see what's going on. Y'all see me? I'm in the cloud. But girl, where we going tonight? We kicking it? What? I know. Yeah. I want to see what's going on. And what you're telling God is your presence ain't more important than their presence. Of course you don't. But you told God in 2017, you ain't did enough for me yet. Because when you fell through, I had to borrow it from pastor, and he gave it to me. So now I shift you from being my supplier in some areas and saying you can be a better supplier. Y'all ain't hearing me. Never mind, let me move on, move on. I gotta get out of here, I gotta get out of here. He says, then I need you, Moses, to separate yourself. From the 70 elders. I need you to come on up a little bit higher.